welcome George Gallaway. The charts?
Yes, why not? I've actually been in the charts already.
Really?
War, what is it good for? I released just after the war, I think, and it went to the top of the charts. It's actually relatively easy now, because people can download music very easily. You don't have to go looking for a record shop to buy music. And,
this is quite different, because it's not you're featured on the single. It's by, will you tell us who it's by?
Well, it's a reprise of a great number from the 60s, which none of you are old enough to remember, by a band called Buffalo Springfield. And we thought it was apposite for this time, when nobody's believing official information, when everyone thinks that Big Brother, the Orwellian Big Brother, is looking over your shoulder all the time. It's basically, everybody, look what's going down. It's asking people to be vigilant about official information, not to trust everything that you've said, but at the same time not to disbelieve everything.
Okay, well, let's have a listen to how you put that to music.
All around the world, people poured, women, labor unions, freedom fighters, all in cyberspace. The ability of the people to speak unto the people, to every corner of the earth, and instantaneously, is going to set the people free, and I, for one, say hallelujah. I, for one, say get it on iTunes, on Amazon, and so on. It's really worth listening to. It's a good treatment of it.
And the lyrics discuss the power of the internet and how messages are getting out now, even to countries where before communication was prohibited, restricted for political reasons or otherwise. How important a role do you think the internet has now in terms of freedom of speech?
I mean, I've got 11,600 videos on YouTube that have been watched by 25 million people. I've got 70,000 friends on Facebook. And so you can reach people in mass numbers now in a way that you would have had to had the permission of big media owners to do before. You know what it's like. Some people get in the media and can get their message across, and other people don't. Maybe their message is too controversial or whatever. But now I can, this here today is being seen by a mass audience on mainstream television. But it will be watched tomorrow on YouTube across the world by anybody who's looking for my name or the causes that I'm speaking for. So I think that this revolution, it's a real revolution, is now fueling revolutions. The revolution in Tunisia, for example, was kind of started by mobile telephones and Facebook and the rest.
So
and
it's
spread like, it really is power to the people. It really is.
So do you tend to question everything, and what are you like with...
Well, I like the statement that a great Irish journalist called Claude Coburn once said, that nothing is true until it's been officially denied. I think that's the healthy attitude of scepticism. At the same time, there is a madness abroad. I mean, I'm already getting messages this morning that the earthquake in Spain overnight was triggered by some sinister, dastardly weapon by someone. I mean, this kind of nonsense, this is a kind
but
of
that's
madness.
That's not helpful to the world, is it?
No,
especially
it's kind
when
of
we live
madness.
In such
but in a way,
times.
Kate, the rulers, our rulers have brought it upon themselves, because actually, very few people in the world any longer believe anything they say, even when they're telling the truth. And, as was joked earlier, good morning, is it? Is the approach now that many people are taking.
You've always tried to take a slightly different approach, especially when it comes to connecting with people and trying to get them to connect with politics, and namely your politics. But did you really think that the Big Brother experience and dressing up as a cat and purring was the way to go?
Well, I mean, that's an example of something that didn't quite work out as planned.
That's a refreshingly honest response,
I really didn't. Well, if I hadn't done the cat so well, we wouldn't be talking about it now. My problem is I'm a perfectionist.
No, George,
if I just
perfectionist,
stopped,
George.
Exactly.
George.
absolutely hideous.
Well, it might have been hideous, but it was a good impression of a cat.
Now,
which is what I was asked
to do. I lost it from behind the cushion. I was going, oh my God, stop it!
It was spookily good, actually. That's the problem.
Yeah, I'd just sat there going, purr, purr, nobody would have remembered it.
Would you do it again, the whole Big Brother thing?
No, I wouldn't do it again, but I don't regret doing it.
Yeah.
I mean, it raised a vast amount of money for charity, which is why I did it, and which everyone forgets. I didn't get the political messages across that I hoped to in the House, because they birdsonged it out, which is something they hadn't told me they would do in advance. But also, I mean, I lost my head in there, as everyone does, after a given amount of time. I started out intending to be Mr. Serene, writing a novel in my head, and I ended up squabbling about tobacco. Where did you get that fag? You didn't have any fags of squabbling. So Big Brother is, you know, he's a clever guy.
It really is. You are our father again for the second time around with your current wife.
Mm-hmm.
How are you finding being a dad later in life? Because you have a grown-up daughter as well.
I do, and my other second child, my son, is 4 tomorrow. So happy birthday, Zane.
Oh, the same birthday as my son. My son's
really?
3 tomorrow, yes.
Ah, well, he's 4.
Are you dressing up
tomorrow?
Like a pirate?
I am a pirate, exactly. He's mad about pirate. I'm definitely not dressing up as a cat. But I've got another one on the way, Kate.
Oh, congratulations.
For Christmas, we're getting another one, God willing.
Oh, well, thank you very much for coming in today and for being so refreshingly straightforward and honest with us. It's George Gallaway.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, George.